Is that it? Is this working? Testing, testing, 1, 2, 3. Yeah, okay, it's working. Hi, me from the past. Okay. I need to turn on the camera, right. Hey guys, welcome back to Phoenix Wright Ace Attorney Trials and Tribulations. Sadly, does not feature Dante from the Devil May Cry series. Where are we now? Tarantino, let me open up the game. Bit late. Busy assembling an IKEA table. Surprisingly difficult. The screws didn't fit correctly. So there's that. That's why I was later than I expected. But it's fine. Bridge to the turnabout investigation now. I'm just gonna give a quick rundown. Let's wait until some music comes. Oh no. Oh god, no. Yeah, no, I'm doing this from the title screen. Okay. Let's go back to the title screen. I don't want to go to Hottie Clinic. Not yet. Definitely not yet. So, last time on just quick rundown, we played as Edgeworth, the greatest defense attorney in the Ace Attorney series, is a prosecutor, apparently. Because goddamn, he makes Wright look like an amateur when he's up on that defense bench. So far, my theory is that the murder actually took place on the inner temple side of the bridge. Then it got launched over the abyss and it landed on the other side of the bridge. That explains the image Larry saw as well as the bruises on the body, after which Iris grabbed the body and took it over to the main temple while Bikini was taking a bath, and she was impaling it with the sword in order to, set up the murder scene when Bikini walked out on her. I'm pretty sure that's what happened. But, let's see. Bridge to the turn. Hottie Clinic. I should have guessed. I'm like, what? Do we know any hospitals in this game? And then I was like, oh, God. Yeah, we know a hospital. February 9th, 343, Hottie Clinic, intensive care unit. There he is. I'm still up at this hour, reading through the record of a certain case. It's the first case my mentor, Mia Fey, ever handled in a court of law. Oh, my microphone is remarkably far away from my face. God damn. That could pose a problem. There we go. Should be better. The horrifying truth that I refuse to accept is holding me hostage here within its pages. Dahlia Hawthorne. Yup. What I have read, I don't want to believe. What is written here, this isn't the Dahlia I knew. I mean, she murdered her past boyfriend and tried to pin it all on you because she used you to, like, get away from different... This woman is basically a serial killer. After falling into Eagle River, I was somehow miraculously saved. But I ended up catching a cold that seemed to knock me around the world and back. I feel dizzy, my ears are ringing, my throat burns, my head is on fire. He took a pretty big fall, but I will recover. I have to recover by this afternoon. I have to meet with the most ill-tempered witness imaginable. But I know that he will be able to help me with him. Somehow. Edgeworth and Phoenix working together is something I'll never get old. February 9th, 2:43 p.m. Dusky Bridge. Right. Are you sure you're well enough to be doing this? You still look a little green in the face. Well, maybe a Viridian in artist speak. Actually, my fever has gone down quite a bit. Oh, that's sad. I was quite enjoying being a defense attorney for a turn. You want to take the pro? I'd like to continue this. Would you like to take the prosecution on this case? Sure. Although I don't think Miss Von Karma would be too happy about that. Yeah, you'd probably get quite a whipping. Miss Von Karma's a pretty scary pal. How's your temperature now? Only 102.2 degrees. Nothing to worry about. Anyways, I read today's trial record. You aren't bad, Edgeworth. Pretty impressive despite the circumstances. We're not in the clear yet. The main point of contention tomorrow is going to be the murder weapon. Yeah. In the end, the Shichishito did not deliver the deadly blow, which means there must be another sword hiding out there that we don't know about. Another sword, huh?
Eh, hey, don't you worry about a thing, pal. I'll dig up the murder weapon myself, or I'll eat my coat.
Thanks again, Edgeworth. I handle things from here. That is probably for the best. Actually, I was thinking about paying the old precinct a little visit. There's something I want to look into. And that is? A client's background, naturally.
Eh, you mean Iris, sir?
I have the feeling that we've met before.
Phoenix knows what's up.
All I want is confirmation, one way or the other. And since I probably won't be getting that from you, I'm sorry, Edgeworth. I bid you adieu, right? Take care.
No, don't go! Eh, I guess I should get moving too.
Why? You need to be somewhere?
Eh, I've got to work on the bridge, pal. And I'm rigging something up so we can get across to the other side.
That's right, Maya's still stuck over there at the inner temple.
Yeah, but don't worry, pal. Soon as it's all set, you'll be the first to know.
Now, thanks, Gumshoe.
Eh, no problem, pal. Just try not to give me that cough of yours, okay? I mean, I don't want to get the Rona, pal. Alright, I'm off.
Thanks, Gumshoe.
Hang in there, Maya. We'll get you out, I promise. But in the meantime, I've got to continue collecting evidence.
Okay, so Edgeworth is actually doing the smart thing and actually looking into Dahlia's past. Good, 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 good. I guess we'll handle the dumb investigation for the time being. Let's check out Heavenly Hall first, since I doubt there'll be anything useful there. So what does Phoenix have to say about the bridge? That thing looks like it's ready to collapse, at least more than it did before. According to Bikini, Eagle Mountain is very prone to earthquakes, which reminds me. My memory serves me correctly, Edgeworth isn't exactly a fan of earthquakes. That he is not. It really feels more of a dusty bridge than a dusky bridge. A kidnapping incident happened here 11 years ago, so maybe it's cursed too. Yeah, probably. Cursed by none other than Dahlia Hawthorne's very presence. February 9th, Heavenly Hall. It's a startlessly good self-portrait. It looks like no one's here.
Larry! Larice!
I'm sure he'd be hiding here. I guess I'll try again later. Can we, like, look inside? Look at this graffiti scrawled right on the front of the shack. At least manages to get a pretty good likeness. I really think about it. I guess art kind of suits him. Yeah, he seems pretty talented. I mean, his very existence is an art. Of sorts. My god, Phoenix. She's rude. That stuff is really ruining the beautiful atmosphere around here. It's so inappropriate. Like Sister Bikini in a bikini. I gotta think of the kittens. Go to r/eyebleach. You'll be fine. Alright, back to the, main gate. February 9th, Hazuker Temple main gate. Come on, please,
It's for art's sake, I swear!
There's only one guy I know who could be this persistent and high-strung.
I'm talking about the heroine here. The heroine in my book. I'll make you famous.
Enough! A fool's fool's fool fool who foolishly accepts the foolishness of foolish fools.
Okay, I need to back up. A fool's fool. Okay. Fool's fools who foolishly. Okay, so. We got the fools, right? Okay. So this fool is the subject of the sentence. A fool's fool. Right, okay, so we have a fool. This is all just one big subject. Fools is the verb. Fools is the object. Fools, fools, right? Plural. Who foolishly accept the foolishness of a fool's fool. Bringing it back to the subject. This is too advanced for me. I mean, I don't... This is English at a...
This is, you know, PhD in writing type shit, you know? Is that even a thing? I don't know.
Wouldn't you agree, Phoenix Wright? The foolishless of all, the foolish most of all foolish fools.
Ah, me? Wait a second, I know you, you're a, ow!
Your reflexes and mine need to sharpen up.
Oh, my brain's flying like a sunny side up and you want me to grill me, and you want to grill me over a name? Francie, you can't do that. Even as we speak, Neek's on the brink of death. They're so dope.
Whip a dead horse. Isn't that one of your American sayings?
No, it's not. I'm not on the brink of anything. Come on, Neek. Tell her, would you? Tell her she needs to model for my picture book, Francie's Whippity Whip Trip. Ah! Fucking, I'd buy that.
Before you ask me to model, learn to give me at least a semi-coherent testimony.
And before that, you'll have to learn how to live a semi-coherent life, Larry. Or, Laurie, sorry. I don't care what anyone says, I'm telling the truth! I saw what I saw! She flew, I'm telling you! Whoosh! Just like that dude with the red underwear! I don't think I'm ever gonna forgive you guys when you come crawling back to apologize! Ah, off he goes. He is impossible to deal with.
It's amazing how little has changed with you in the past year, Phoenix Wright.
Oh, we got to talk to Franziska, the best girl. You've been in Germany all this time.
That's right, extending my perfect win record naturally.
Yeah, about that, you got a couple of losses there. Oh joy, sounds like she hasn't changed a bit. Has it really been a year since we first met? Yeah, it's been a year since Turnabout, since Reunion and Turnabout, and a year more since Rise from the Ashes.
I'm Franziska von Karma, the prodigy.
I see.
I gave up a promising career in Germany and came to this country for one sole reason. Revenge.
Franziska was born and raised in Germany. Became a prosecutor at the age of 13. Her father was the legendary prosecutor Manfred von Karma. She had a perfect win record for 40 long years, but now, he is gone from this world. Yep. Good riddance. Good fucking riddance. Don't tell me you still hold a grudge against me because of what happened to your father.
Phoenix Wright, you will fall before me, this I promise. But it will be for my sake, not my father's. Are we clear?
Yes, Crystal.
In truth, I was shocked. I came back to America, with the intention of defeating you.
So what? You're just, acknowledging the fact that I'm gonna end up beating you again?
Instead, it was my little brother who was leading the defense.
Little brother who is several years older than you. Got it. Edgeworth, come to think of it, Edgeworth was pulled into being a prosecutor by Manfred von Karma as well.
Miles Edgeworth told me something very interesting, you know? He said this case has a special significance to you.
Because it does.
And that's precisely why I am here.
More Daijoubu! I forgot what the second part is. Is it Watase ga kita? I know it ends in kita, but Watashi ga kita. Yeah, okay. More Daijoubu! Watashi ga kita! I think that's how it goes.
Your personal involvement will make crushing you into teeny-weensy pieces all the better.
Oh, you're improving your vocabulary, Von Karma. Yesterday you would have said foolishly foolish pieces, but, good to know you're learning. You're learning your English, you're expanding your vocabulary. Are you using, Duolingo? Yeah, it's probably a fever, but she's so openly hostile that it's almost kind of cute. It is! It is!
Ow! No smirking!
You know what? I would ship it, but Wrightworth is just so much better. No whipping the sick!
The foolish fool doing such foolishly favor, doing a foolish favor for such a foolishly foolish fool.
Edgeworth.
Make no mistake, Phoenix Wright. I came here for one thing and one thing only. To pulverize you.
It's not like I thought you were here to bring me some Cold Killer X, you know? Well, the last person that brought you Cold Killer X was trying to murder you, Phoenix.
Ken went over the whole case file on the flight over.
You read the whole thing?
Yes, every last word of every last sentence of every last paragraph. All the ridiculous things you did made it very interesting read, you know.
Oh, I love Franziska. She, invokes certain feelings, let's just say.
Attempting to cross a burning bridge. Did you even consider the dangers?
No. The only thing I thought in my mind was I have to get across.
A fool who doesn't think is more foolish than a fool who foolishly thinks.
No, no, honestly, I would argue that not thinking is probably often better than thinking incorrectly. Gumshoe said he'd let me know once the bridge was repaired. Ah, yeah, she's got to be okay. I just know it. Plus, I need to ask her about what really happened on the inner temple that night.
True.
We'll see which, testimony she can corroborate. Although I'm pretty sure she is going to say that she saw Iris. Although I'm guessing that wasn't Iris and that was in fact Dahlia. Occult. Anyone want to show her?
Attorney's badge! About this- Ow! I refuse to help you, Phoenix, right?
I should have known better than to try. Okay, looks like we're not getting much out of this. What a portrait. Horrible sketch on the outcropping. This testimony, at least his autopsy report. My all important badge shows that I'm a defense attorney. Alright, let's take a look. Cardo. Is Etrothine added? Yes. Okay. Let's take a look. AKA Larry Butts. Saw an unbelievable sight at Heavenly Hall the night of the crime.
Okay.
Legendary prosecutor Manfred von Karma's daughter became a prosecutor in Germany at age 13. Also a cutie. My old friend, said to be number one in the DA's office. Studies foreign judicial systems now. Also a cutie. Alright, well, I guess Franziska, we're done here. You wanna go... You wanna discuss the case over some coffee later, maybe? You know? That'd be nice. Alright, let's go to the main hall. Let's stop simping. I'm done simping for the day. February 9th, Hasakura Temple, main hall. I need to save my simp energy for Shin Megami Tensei 3 Nocturne and Pixie. February 9th, Hasakura Temple, main hall. Oh yeah, Nocturne, by the way, tomorrow at 3. Don't miss it, you piece of shit. Because Shin Megami Tensei 5 finally got fucking announced, so we might want to step up our pace with that game. That was one long sigh. Sister Bikini?
My! I didn't know you were here! How are you doing?
It's the way her cheeks just fluctuate as she laughs.
Oh.
You don't have to pretend to be in a good mood for my sakes.
I suppose I've made a terrible mess of things, haven't I? I let Mystic Elise die, and then there's Iris as well.
Mystic Elise. Now that I think about it,
there's an acolyte stuck at the inner temple, and that poor little girl has gone missing too.
That little girl? You don't mean Pearls, do you?
Yes, I'm afraid I do. She hasn't been seen since the morning after the incident.
I mean, it's quite possible that she headed over the bridge to go meet with Maya. So if I had to guess, she's probably at the inner temple. That seems like the most likely place for her to be. I mean, she has to be hiding somewhere, and this place has already been searched top to bottom. She can't be outside because she would have already frozen to death. I mean, unless her spirit medium training lets her survive out in the cold or some shit. Pearls, she's missing? Why didn't anyone tell me about this? Fucking Edgeworth.
I must be getting old. I think I've seriously lost faith in myself.
You're talking about your performance at the trial today?
You believe me, don't you? I'm not a liar. I would never lie. I know what I saw. I saw Iris pull that sword from Mystic Elise's body that night. I'm certain of it. At least, I was until this morning.
I don't see any psyche locks, so she must be telling the truth. So why are you so unsure of yourself all of a sudden?
You know that artist who testified after me? I saw her flying, her white foot fluttering. I felt like I might start flying myself.
When I saw that man testify so fervently about something so impossible, I started to wonder if I had acted just like him when I was on the witness stand.
I wouldn't take that guy too seriously. He's an artist, but all he draws is trouble. And nothing else. If both Bikini and Larry are telling the truth, that can only mean one thing. They both didn't see what they think they saw. Yep.
On the night of the incident, you met Iris at the Inner Temple. Is that correct?
That's right. I'm sure it was Iris.
But Iris claims she was in the room at Hazakura Temple.
I knew I shouldn't have come back here that night.
But because you did, Maya is stuck all by herself at the Inner Temple.
Oh, I'm so sorry. The drafts in that place are nothing to shake a stick at. Winter's especially bad.
I'll bet. The training hall looks like it's about to fall down any second.
Eagle Mountain has always been prone to earthquakes, just so you know.
Earthquakes?
Yes, I would be surprised if the next big one levels the training hall.
We gotta get Maya out of there fast!
But still, there's really no need to worry. There are areas on the other side of Dusky Bridge. The area on the other side of Dusky Bridge is isolated like an island.
It's like an island, how so?
Well, the only thing on that side of the bridge is the Inner Temple. No one lives out there, and it's surrounded on all sides by the river or the forest.
I see.
So a criminal would be trapped should they choose to flee in that direction. As long as the bridge is out of commission, he or she will have to stay there.
Yeah, but they could just jump into the river, right? And if you take a look at the map... Oh, no, that's Elise. That's the thumbnail. I mean, there's a lot of out, but again, it does seem to get a bit thinner. I think you can make this jump. You can make a jump from here onto the water, I'm pretty sure. If you want to be safe, you could always, you know. You could maybe climb up here and then jump from here into the water. Or maybe down here, it gets a bit closer. Not sure, but yeah, you should be able to jump into the river at some points, right? That means Maya could be stuck out there with a murderer and no way to escape either?
Oh dear, yes, I suppose it does.
Oh, please, Gumshoe, get that bridge up faster. I'm curious about a few things, if you don't mind answering some questions.
Oh, do you need to know my measurements for your investigation or something?
No. I want to know a little more about the victim, Miss Elise Doxenham.
I'm afraid I don't know her waist size, or her bust size for that matter.
Damn it! No! I'm wondering why she would come to stay in a place like this to begin with. Do you have Von Karmas? I mean, she told us herself that she wasn't here for spiritual training.
My, you make it sound like this place is some sort of dump, Mr. Wright. Miss Elise was here to soak up the natural beauty of Eagle Mountain, if you must know.
There, you did it again. Sister Bikini.
I notice you always refer to Miss Doxenham as Mystic Elise. Yep.
Oh!
Yeah, so likely she knows Elise's true identity of Misty Fae. She's just choosing to keep it hidden. Yes, now why is that? After all, she's not here as an acolyte.
Oh, we address all our visitors as Mystic. It makes their experience feel authentic.
You just admitted to being a fraud! Okay, then call me... I haven't been called Mystic Phoenix. It's really fucking cringy, but also kind of cool at the same time, you know? Alright, I'm gonna go get a Coca-Cola real quick. Just so that, I just gotta go ahead and get it, then I won't crave it later. This seems like a... Actually, no, let's finish this dialogue real quick.
And anyway, she's older than me. You must respect your elders, you know?
Oh, she's older than you. Now that is very useful information, in fact. Older than 48? Yeah, that makes sense for Elise. Oh, I'm still in the Be Right Back screen. There we go. Sorry. You must respect your elders, you know?
How do you know that?
How can I say for sure that she's older than you?
Womp womp.
Damn it! Oh god, that's a lot of locks!
Pretty sure that's more locks than fucking Iris had about our relationship.
And it seems Miss Elise Doxnam was no ordinary visitor after all.
And there's pearls. She was Miss Doxnam on the evening of the murder, and now she's vanished. It's all got to be connected somehow.
It is.
All right, I'm gonna go get that Coca-Cola now, and I'll be right back. Take this opportunity.
Thank you. Thank you.
I'm muted. I was fucking muted. I'm so sorry. Wow. That was... Why? Oh, God. Well, I guess it's fine now. Let's just keep going. Oh, it's empty?
How naive of you, Phoenix Wright.
It's a bit strange such a thing, Franziska von Karma. I seem to remember. Mm-hmm. There's snow on this incinerator the first time I saw it. Yeah, the snow melted because someone used the incinerator and the heat melted the snow. In other words, someone's been using it to burn something recently.
Listen, Phoenix Wright, it's impertinent to call people by their full name.
I was only copying you. Oh, I was expecting to get whipped there. Surprisingly, no.
Cool.
All right. It's a little gate that leads into the garden. It says no entry on the sign, though.
Come on now, Phoenix Wright. What are you doing? Let's go in. It's half open anyways. What harm could come of it?
But it says no entry!
Don't you Americans enjoy doing whatever you like and then simply say whatever?
You're not an American!
reckon? You're a prosecutor. Shouldn't you be the one respecting rules and stuff? It's got nothing to do with anything. And who told you that? I guess she isn't on karma, so it makes sense. Fucking breaking the law to get criminals convicted all the time. This will see the door that leads to the inner temple, where Ma Fei was training on the night of the murder. Fuck! Oh my god. I just spilled coke all over my desk. Dear lord. Oh, shit. That's not good. We're gonna take like a 10-minute break. I'm gonna clean all this up and I'll be back, okay?
Alright, I've cleaned out my keyboard, and, however, now I need it to dry out, because, god damn it, it was Coke, not just water, so I had to actually wash it out. I've got a backup keyboard here. It's a backup, but it's kind of broken. Some of the keys don't work. Hopefully that won't be an issue. Let's get back to it. I'm just gonna finish this Coke so I don't spill any more of it. God damn it. Would you believe me if this is the second time this exact thing has happened? Like, the reason why this keyboard, some of the keys don't work, is because I spilled Coke on it, like, last week. I should really not be allowed near technology. I'm a fucking hazard. I really am. Where's my phone? The fuck did I put my phone? Need it for chat. There we go. Got it. Motherfucker. Huh? My headphones just powered off on their own. Okay, good to know. Come on. This is not my fucking day. This is not my fucking day, apparently. Okay, well, they seem on. Let's hope they're on. We got some music. Where Maya Faye was training on the night of the murder. Yes, there's a solitary room there called the training hall. You could do with some training yourself, Phoenix Wright. Training for what? I'm in perfect shape, I'll have you know. Have you seen that man? He's no JoJo character, but he's pretty good. Hey, you're pretty good. Ow! You're completely out of shape. I don't know how much more of this woman I can take. Can we... really? No music. Okay, well, in that case... Q works, okay. Backspace works, okay. We're trying to figure out what works and what doesn't in this fucking thing. Okay, yeah, looks like audio is working fine. And there's a psyche lock on the door! Neat. February 9th, Inner Temple Training Hall, and someone spilled tea on the Amy Faye picture. Possibly on purpose, so that we wouldn't be able to figure out her identity, maybe? I mean, after all, we'd all be looking very closely at, Elise now, since she's dead, so maybe. What's wrong? Why are you so quiet? She's supposed to be in here training. I like the fact that Von Karma, you actually see her investigating, right? Unlike, say, Edgeworth or Gatto, who, like, I know Edgeworth, like, does kind of investigate, or at least lets detectives do the work. Gatto, I'm pretty sure he doesn't even investigate the crime scene. He just shows up at the fucking trial and just tries to delay and bullshit his way through it. And, of course, we beat his ass every single time. She was supposed to be in here training, yet it appears she's nowhere to be seen. What's that? A strange lock. Well, there 2 days ago. The whole room is really giving off some strange vibes. Alright, we gotta perform a vibe check, I guess. And it has failed. It's an antique dresser. Don't you dare open it, Phoenix Wright! Now I know how Maya feels when I tell her not to touch things. I mean, it's basically the same thing. What a pity. It's full of nothing but old clothes for the acolytes. I thought we weren't opening it. I'm from the prosecutor's office. I can do anything. Summarize the Ace Attorney franchise in one sentence. And there you have it. There you have it. Yeah, you can do anything except stand up to a 9-year-old girl. Let's take a look at the picture. What do you think this yellowish poster is, Phoenix Wright? That's a scroll, not a poster. Picture of a woman who's actually...
A woman? I don't see any woman here.
A different atmosphere in this room since the last time I was here.
No, it's not a different atmosphere. It's a different smell.
It's shit stains. Someone just had explosive diarrhea all over the wall. It's gravy.
What's the matter?
A scroll that's been completely covered in gravy.
Ah, yes, there's a very appetizing smell in the air. But gravy is a type of sauce. So when you run out of paint, you Americans use gravy as a substitute. I see.
I don't... Okay.
No, no one does that. For starters, it stinks.
This is a modern art shit.
This must be... It really sounds like a modern art piece name.
Gravy and shit stinks.
This would be the gravy that we had on... with the roast on the night of the incident.
Right, so someone came here after the roast with some gravy.
Why would anyone do this? Why this scroll? Misty Faye's image obscured with gravy.
Yuki?
Scroll shows a picture of Misty Faye, master of the Kurang channel. Why would anyone cover it in gravy?
I can't make out what's drawn on the scroll at all. I'll never understand you Americans and your so-called artists.
Artists?
Yeah, sure.
Leave it at that.
This door.
That was here 2 days ago. This weird lock wasn't on it.
Those chains. It's almost as if they're guarding something inside the cavern. I've never seen a lock quite like this before.
I have. Seen locks and chains just like this before. Look just like the ones that guard a person's secrets during a psyche lock. Wonder if this lock is guarding something too. Dark secrets in a dark cavern. What took you so long?
Maya?
Not even you'd managed to get here faster than this.
Oh no! Gato!
I thought even you'd managed to get here faster than this, Mr. Trite.
What are you doing here right after I joked about you not investigating? It's not even your case! This is not even your case!
Of which is something you have no hope of ever understanding.
Enough! I believe I have the measure of you. You are the very worst kind of prosecutor. What could be more important than a trial? She's so fucking right! Oh my god! I never thought I'd be agreeing with Von Karma, but here we are!
Who's the wild mare, Trite?
This is Ms. Von Karma. She's the acting prosecutor in your absence today.
Well... I guess I owe you one, then. But you can go now, princess. It's time for the big boys to take the reins.
You're only big in your stature! Your brain is fucking tiny!
Just who do you think you are? This case is my-
Hey, Philly. Know your role and shut your mouth. I can't stand women like you.
He's not really making him- He's really not helping his case right now.
I'm only going to say this once, Lady Von Whippenberg. Go home.
Okay, that's a good fucking line, Lady Von Whippenberg.
Phoenix, right!
What are you hitting me for?
You deserve more craps of the whip than that, right?
What?
You still don't get it, do you? You don't realize that you set something in motion that you'll never be able to undo.
You can't actually blame him for your fucking getting poisoned, can you? I mean, I know you're dumb, Gato, but you can't be this dumb.
Something different about Gato today. I'm getting such a strong sense of something from behind his mask. Is it anger or is it sorrow? What the fuck are you doing here? You had some important business and that's why you weren't in court, huh? So what was it?
I've told you once before, but perhaps you don't remember. I've returned from the depths of hell to do battle with you. You see, Trite, I experienced something most have not. Death.
You died?
Of course. Being extradited from hell is a tedious affair. The meticulous regeneration and adjustment of all your internal organs is Well, let's just say modern medicine allows us to live to a ripe old age. Even someone like me.
So, you mean that mask you wear is...
this ugly device? I promise it's not a fashion statement, my unenlightened friend. Without this, I can't see your frequently dumbfounded face.
Didn't know.
My eyesight is pretty messed up. Even with these huge goggles on my head, I still can't see everything.
You can't see the color red, right?
Still, I keep this worn-out piece of junk of a body going with regular servicing.
I'm sorry, but you say you experienced death. How's that possible? What happened?
Poisoning.
Why don't you ask him?
Me? So he does hold me responsible? God, oh, you can't be this dumb.
Yeah, Trite, you should know all about it. You know when my life ended, and who ended it for me.
Well, Phoenix Wright, do you? Don't know what he's talking about!
Although, to be honest, I do feel a little tug at the corner of my memory. I think I do know about how Gato was killed.
It will all become clear in due time. Isn't that right, Trite?
Earlier you said I've done something I can never undo. What do you mean by that exactly?
The inner temple here on this side of Dusky Bridge is an isolated island.
That's what Mr. Bikini said so too.
No wonder, Trite. You know what the police are doing here today?
What do you mean?
They're searching. Searching for any trace of an acolyte who went missing.
Missing?
As leader of the search party, I can tell you this with absolute certainty. My fae is not on this side of Dusky Bridge.
Huh? But that's impossible. She came here that night and...
I won't say it again. Chances of her being here are nil. It's gonna be, of course, one very unique place.
One? Where's that?
The sacred cavern. The entrance of which we're standing at right now.
Right.
This is the only place that the search party has yet to explore.
So they haven't searched the cavern yet, huh? Well, that's where she trained, so of course she's gonna be there, you fucking idiot! This is why you're dumb!
Beware, though, that the temperature inside frequently falls below freezing.
That's kind of the point, you know?
Even if she were in there, chances of her being found alive are slim at best.
No!
Which means, Trite, that you sent Maya Fae to her death.
God, what is this? Are you dumb? Like, with every statement you utter, your perceived IQ drops by like 10 points. You're getting to the negatives here, my man.
You fool. If that's the situation, why aren't you there with the search party right now?
You must have blinders on, my equestrian angel. Don't you see that big lock and chains? It's a trick lock. Now I'm making preparations to open it as we speak.
Trick lock my ass, Guardian, not that motherfucker! Cut it in half!
Well, Trite, once again, a woman dies because of you.
You're not blaming me for Mia! No, 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 no! You are not! You are not! Oh, hi, Mark. Once again, what are you talking about?
Don't tell me you've forgotten. It was only 2 years ago, after all, when the last unfortunate woman died because of you.
Because of me?
And do you know who that was? It was Maya Fae's sister. That's right, Mia Fae.
His idiocy knows no bounds! It's actually astonishing! If his view of these events that are clearly documented in, like, every single court record, like, you can just dig up the fucking court files, my dude. You can read the fucking court record. Like, these are such well-documented events. The fact that you don't know how they went down is just more proof of how fucking dumb you are, dude! Mia?
You killed her!
No, that's not how it was.
It was 2 years ago. Mia Fey was pursuing someone. Man, she bit off more than she could chew. Made a very dangerous enemy.
Red White. Yeah, that's one case I'll never forget. But I got the guy, personally.
Sure. Miss Faye's murderer was caught. But that won't bring her back.
Well, no, but...
You were with her at the time. You and no one else. It was your responsibility. You should have protected her. You say Mia Fey was your teacher. Well, then I'd say you've learned nothing, Trite. You robbed her of her life, and now you've let her sister suffer the same fate.
I haven't sentenced Maya to death. No! Don't let him get to you. He is the foolish fool that Von Karma keeps referring to. What is this peculiar-looking lock? Why don't we just break it open? It would be simple. It would be a simple matter of...
I'm afraid we can't do that. This area has always been prone to earthquakes. The repeated tremors have weakened the foundations in the training hall. Any excessive force to break this lock would... Well, let's just say the inner temple and the sacred cavern would be a thing of the past.
Oh, come on! Just bring the fucking angle grinder! It'll be fine!
Very well, then there suggests the obvious solution of opening it with a key.
Sure. Just show me where the keyhole is on this trick lock.
There's no keyhole!
That's right. An interesting puzzle, huh? The person who set this lock is the only one who can open it.
And who was it?
Simple. The accused.
What, Iris?
When an acolyte undergoes training inside the sacred cavern, the attending sisters is responsible for locking the entrance.
That seems... very dangerous. Definitely to violate some kind of code.
Obviously, the night of murder was no exception. My Fae was trained in there.
Definitely an OSHA violation of some kind, you know? Oh great, the alt key doesn't work, so I can't even alt tab out of the game. Fantastic. Oh, this is just what I wanted. Sister Bikini did mention a number of times, now that I think about it, said that Iris was left in charge of supervising the early stages of the training.
So Iris was accused. So Iris, the accused, is the only one who can open this lock. I've arranged for her to be brought here now.
Iris is the only person who can open this lock. I hope she gets here soon. Hang in there, Maya. Get you out.
So, I should be getting back to work.
My God, how sure are you about Maya?
There's no doubt in my mind.
Well, then that means she's alive, because every single thing you've ever said has been wrong.
She's in the sacred cavern somewhere. It's the only place she could be. You'd better start praying. You better pray that friend of yours brings the accused back here soon.
Edgeworth?
Listen up, Trite. There's only one thing I want to say before I go. I'll never accept you. Never.
I don't care! I don't want your acceptance!
You should choose your friends more carefully, Phoenix Wright.
Edgeworth accepts me! Hell, even Von Karma accepts me to a degree! Fucking Chief Gant accepts me. Judge accepts me. Maya accepts me. Mia accepted me. There's a lot of people that accept me. And honestly, if you accepted me, I'd say that would be an attraction to my skills. More than anything. That's what everyone says. Looks like I don't have much of a choice. Guess I'll just have to do what I can for now. Okay. I mean, if it's a trick lock, then it should be openable, right? It should be some kind of puzzle. Guess not, though. I don't know, should I or shouldn't I? Looks like someone's talking to himself. Where's that coming from? Larry? Oh, no. Yeah, I guess I better wash that off. That's what I'll do. Oh, but I can't do that. I'm a detective. Ah, my brain is driving me nuts. Ah!
Is something troubling you, Scruffy?
Yeah, please don't whip me like that all of a sudden, sir.
It's merely a simple greeting, a friendly tap on the shoulder, with my whip.
So what's up, Gumshoe? Something on your mind?
How do you know, pal? Perhaps you were trying to decide if you wanted to wash that off or not.
How do you know, sir? Oh yeah, I near forgot. You can go through the little gate there, okay?
You mean the one that says no entry on it?
I kinda already snuck in there.
You trying to be clever or something?
So, what's behind there, Scruffy?
I kinda garden.
It's a cute nickname, you know? Scruffy. A garden?
Anyways, it's under investigation right now, so keep out! And I'm not telling you, I'm asking you, pal. You got me?
Not telling you? Oh, sure.
Is it normally the other way around?
Yeah, well, see you later.
So, shall we adjourn to this garden, Phoenix Wright?
Of course. What else would we do?
Man, I love having Von Karma as a partner. She's great.
I really want to know if Gumshoe was thinking of washing off.
The garden.
Oh, for fuck's sake. We'll deal with that in a second. February 9th, Inner Temple Garden.
There's a strange feeling in the air. I wonder what it is.
Strange feeling? Forgot about that! What's that strange writing on the stone lantern?
Maya. Question being, why is it upside down?
What are you doing here, sir? I thought I said you can't come in here.
Don't you know, Scruffy? A Von Karma will always show up wherever there is a clue. And there are plenty of clues to be found here.
I'm gonna lose my job, pal.
Alright, let's take a look around. Blood here, so very likely this is the site of the murder. Although I still can't find any kind of sword. That's obviously Maya upside down. The question is, why is it upside down, you know?
What the heck is that?
Uh-oh. Yeah, you spotted it, huh, pal?
Are you kidding me? It could be more obvious.
It says Maya.
Yeah, and before you ask, it's written in blood. Not ketchup, pal. Not ketchup.
I will answer all our questions now, Scruffy, without exception.
Yes, sir.
Okay, what's that? There's a charm or something poking out from the snow. Looks pretty old, and there's a leather cord tied to it, too.
And apparently it belonged to the victim.
To Miss Elise Doxnum.
And there's a broken leather cord around the lady's neck. And the cord found on the victim and the charm match exactly.
Sounds to me like this little trinket is going to be my ticket to getting some very big answers.
Yup, Crane Master's Talisman.
That all but confirms it, essentially.
A little lantern, a little statue. It is certainly a quaint little garden.
Oh!
What is this huge bowl down here for?
Oh, I know this one. It's a water bowl, isn't it?
It's water.
Everything else is completely frozen over, but the ice in this bowl has been broken.
That's true. I wonder if it has any impact on the case.
I dusted my face earlier in this water. I was getting kind of sleepy.
Ah! Next time you're sleepy, you need only come to me, got it?
Yeah, she'll wake you right up. Couple of torches here. I guess you need all the light you can get up here in the mountain.
Yeah, I was looking at those things, pal. It looks like they've been lit pretty recently.
Recently? How recent are we talking about?
Yeah, as recent as the night of the murder.
I was training here on the night of the murder. It's not unreasonable to think these things were lit at the time, I guess. Question is why? Her training was taking place inside, not outside, so... So, how's the Inner Temple investigation going?
And we have the best forensic team in the whole world working that place.
Forensic team? And what was the outcome of the scientific study?
Nothing. Scientifically speaking, a place is as clean as a whistle.
That's very useful.
That's simply not good enough, Scruffy. Do you think I'll let you get away with that?
Uh-oh. Well, there were a couple of things that bothered me when I first got here, sir.
You need Emma Sky on the case. The greatest scientific investigator this world has ever known. That stone lantern in the surrounding area. That's not covered in snow, correct?
Hey, it looked kind of fishy to me, you know? Scientifically speaking. I got the lab boys to look them over. The results were, it was hard to say, actually.
I guess I better look into them myself. About Maya.
Did Mr. Gatto tell you yet?
Yes, we heard.
Yeah, well, he's got a search party out looking for her. There's nowhere else she could have disappeared to on this side of Dusky Bridge. All we can do is wait for Mr. Edgeworth to get here, pal.
Edgeworth?
He's escorting Iris, the defendant, over here.
We'll have to wait, since she is the only one who could open the door to the sacred tavern.
Cavern, fuck. Now, I think Mr. Edgeworth wants to talk to you about something, pal.
Huh?
Wonder what it is. Yeah, so don't be expecting any good news when you talk to him. When I spoke to him, Mr. Edgeworth sounded so down, I felt like I was drowning.
Hot take, small shits are better than big shits, because big ones can kind of scratch while you poop. Don't at me on this.
What the fuck did I just read?
Sounds pleasant.
Okay, that was perfect.
Maya, so these letters are written in blood?
And what's worse is the victim's blood.
Huh? Is it Miss Doxum's blood?
Well, yeah, I'm guessing originally they wanted Maya to be the fall person, right?
By essentially locking her over on this side, she would be in the only place where the murderer could be. When they didn't find any other murderer. And, you know, they'd find the body on the other side impaled with a sword, then they'd search around for the murderer, and Maya would be the only one it could be, right?
You know, we haven't done a detailed analysis yet, but it's looking that way, pal.
Most interesting. Phoenix Wright, I presume you know, don't you? Why Maya's name is written upside down?
Because the victim had her back to the wall and wrote it like that? Right?
Maya. Right?
Hey, you know why that was really bothering me too? It's like, 11037. I just came up with an answer, result of my own special gumshoe. Oh.
There, we're back, and I'm not muted this time.
No, big shits are the shit, man. Pun intended. You just feel so good after a big shit.
The release.
I just came up with the answer. It was my very own special gumshoe investigation.
Really? Do tell.
Yeah, well, on the night of the murder, that stone lantern was upside down.
Gumshoe. Gumshoe. Come on. Can you try? Can we at least try here?
Anyway, there's really only one logical explanation to this mystery. Miss Elise Doxum wrote these letters herself, in her own blood.
You must be joking, that's impossible!
And from the writing of the victim's blood and the other clues left behind, it seems pretty likely that this garden was the scene of Miss Elise Doxum's murder. At least that's our current theory on how the events took place, pal.
What?
Yep.
Nah, you gotta have the big side.
So, Miss Doxum was killed here.
Yeah, whatever you want to look at, that's what people are saying now.
And what Sister Bikini saw in the courtyard of the main temple was...
Well, what was it? It wasn't the scene of the crime, what did she see?
Well, the sword was pulled out and then she was impaled with the Shichishito. So the whole point was to essentially make it look like she committed the murder. Or, I mean, to make it look like Amy Faye killed her.
And what do you think, Ms. Montgarba?
Surely a special gumshoe investigation would reveal the answer, no?
But wait a second, the bloody writing all over the... and all the other clues here. So we could have easily set this all up after the murder, right?
Yeah, sorry, but that's not an option, pal.
Why not? How quickly you forget, Phoenix Wright. Ever since that incident occurred, this place has been completely inaccessible. Because Dusky Bridge was completely burned out.
Yeah, I was overseeing repairs on the bridge the whole time. Well, no one came over here before me and my men. Yeah, which means no one could have planned all this stuff here, pal.
Can't think of a counter-argument to that.
I know it. I should have washed the blood off the lantern as soon as I got here.
If this really was the scene of the crime, then I can't figure out exactly what it was that Bikini actually saw. It just keeps getting weirder, doesn't it? Alright, well, let's go talk to Bikini. Night, Hazakur Temple.
It seems you have a visitor.
Oh, hi there!
Mr. Wright!
Iris, I'm really glad to see you. Kato managed to mobilize the police by claiming a state of emergency.
Not him again.
No, never mind him. We've got to hurry and unlock the secret cavern.
I'm sorry, Mr. Wright. It's my fault someone so important to you is locked down there. Mr. Wright, Truth, can we finish our conversation later?
Alright. Let's hurry to the inner temple then. I'll see you later, right?
Hold it!
Yeah. Wait, Edgeworth, I'm coming with you guys. Sorry, right? I can't allow you to come with us.
What?
I hate to be the one to break it to you, but my Fae is in a rather delicate position.
What do you mean by delicate position?
This isn't simply a rescue operation, right? It's also an investigation. That being the case, you can't allow members of the public to interfere.
I'm not a member of the public, I'm the fucking defense!
Come on, Edgeworth! If anything happens, you'll be the first to know. Please understand, right?
But Maya! Mr. Wright, no! I want to see Edgeworth interact with Gatto! This is like the one thing I've been waiting for! All that matters is that Mystic Maya is rescued, correct? No, I don't give a shit about Maya! I want to see Edgeworth talk to Gatto and tell him how much of an idiot he is! Listen to the voice of reason for a change, Phoenix Wright.
From now on, consider everything beyond Dusky Bridge to be off limits. We'll be going now. Excuse us.
Ah! There's no time to be standing around, Phoenix Wright. There are other things that demand your attention.
She's right. Thanks for reminding me. You're actually being helpful. Damn it! February 9th, Hazakur Temple, Main Hall. Sister Bikini looks like she's shrunk some since I last saw her.
Don't be so rude, Phoenix Wright. What's wrong, Sister Bikini?
My, my, my. Hello, you two. How are you doing?
The sound of that sigh, I guess she's still pretty down.
Iris was just here, you know? She was accompanied by some handsome, crimson-clad prince.
She talking about Edgeworth?
It was just a courtesy call. I wasn't allowed to talk to her at all. Oh dear, it's all my fault that this has happened. Oh, Iris! She was worried about my back, would you believe? What have I done to her?
Only what you had to do, sister. You bravely and truthfully testified about what you saw. There's no shame in that. And we'll see to it that your testimony wasn't made in vain.
Oh, I'll make sure.
Well, I don't hear anyone else saying that. Mr. Bluesuit doesn't seem to share your opinion, I see.
Me! Ah! Gee.
Oh, yes, you did great, Sister Bikini.
Absolutely spectacular!
You two are the only ones who've said that to me!
I can't shake the feeling that I just became a shill and a shrew.
Do you have a problem, Phoenix Wright?
Sure, she was brave to testify so truthfully like that, but I know she's still hiding something. I guess it's time to break those psyche locks of hers. Alright, sure, let's go for it.
Take that!
Finally have proof. Elise Doxnin. Alright, we've already seen this. This is because of the talisman.
Take that!
Miss Doxnam had this charm with her at all times.
Ah, where did you...
This isn't some cheap good luck charm either.
Then... Oh, what do you think it is, Mr. Wright? Oh, what could a talisman like that possibly mean?
It's a talisman, is it? Interesting.
Oops!
This thing speaks volumes about who Miss Doxnam really was. This talisman and other... and one other item unequivocally prove Miss Doxnam's true identity. The... scroll?
Take that!
Yeah, okay. The painting is obscured by the gravy stains at the moment. But this scroll shows the master of the Kurain channeling technique. The crest on top of that sign of the honorable title. The very same crest that adorns the talisman the victim carried with her.
Ah!
The crest is reserved for the master of Kurain.
What on earth told you that nonsense? I've got no idea what you're talking about.
The new master, Maya Faye, told me.
What? You mean that acolyte is Misty Faye's...
daughter? Yes.
Are you sure?
Yes. In fact, since her eldest daughter passed away, Maya is Misty Faye's sole successor.
Mystic Misty!
Oh, that was an easy one, I guess. You're really not good at keeping secrets, are you? Or lying.
Mystic Elise graced us with her presence about a week ago. When she showed me the talisman with the mark on it, well, I nearly fainted. Nor did it seem her since she disappeared 17 years ago, after all.
What is the significance of this talisman, sister?
The Kurain talisman. It's a symbol of the master of Kurain. The bearer must carry it with them, always, until their death.
Until their death. So Elise Doxum was really Maya's mother, huh?
She is Misty Faye, the master of the Kurain channeling technique.
Truth comes out at last. Looks like we're making some headway here.
Tell me, sister. After 17 years, why does she choose to show herself now?
Because something happened that called her out of hiding.
What happened?
Well...
No, Edgeworth! No, we must rush to the protection of Best Boy! No, he needs a hug right now!
What's happening?
It can't be.
Earthquake! Oh my goodness! The inner temple! This kind of tremorite!
The inner temple!
A secret cavern of the training hall! It might very well cave in!
What?
Maya! No! Edgeworth! Fuck Maya!
It seems to have passed!
We can't just stare here and do nothing! Let's go!
What? Where?
The inner temple, of course! What else?
Sister Bikini, we'll finish this later, all right?
Of course! You run along now! People may have been hurt! I must get some first aid kits ready!
Call an ambulance! Call an ambulance!
Come on then, Phoenix Wright! They won't bar you from entering as long as I'm with you!
Thank you!
Right at that moment, I had the worst feeling in my gut.
We just had an earthquake.
I wonder if he's alright. He needs a hug!
You look worried. They're thinking about Miles Edgeworth.
Come on, let's go.
Edgeworth Protection Squad, let's head out!
You've got it, Phoenix Wright.
You've got to hurry to the inner temple end.
Right! Ah, what are you doing here?
How could I have...
How do you expect us to understand if you don't speak up?
Ow! Hey, why am I the one getting whipped?
She's gone.
No!
The defendant Iris. She's gone. Which means that Maya is gonna be the new defendant if she's alive, you know.
Gone where?
She fled. She escaped.
What?
So, it was just now. During the... Man needs a hug. It's easy to see Edgeworth's one and only weakness. His fear of earthquakes. I should have known better than to escort the defendant alone.
As soon as the ground started shaking, everything went dark before my eyes, and I stupidly passed out. That incident haunts you to this day, doesn't it? That's no excuse for letting the suspect get away. I can't believe I let it happen. Right, the inner temple area is a dead end, so she could have only escaped to this side. We haven't seen her. Then we need to get a manhunt underway now and search Eagle Mountain from top to bottom. Wait, Edgeworth, have you thoroughly checked the inner temple yet? Don't be ridiculous, why would I? The inner temple is like an island, there's no way to escape but across. No, that's not it. Iris isn't the type of person to run away, Edgeworth. What are you talking about? Sister Bikini mentioned something while we were with her. She said the sacred cavern might have caved in because of the quake.
Then you think Iris might have gone to the inner temple to check out the situation?
Listen, Edgeworth, I'm sure she's at the inner temple. A manhunt is not necessary.
I mean, it could hurt.
Right. Let's not waste any more time. We need to get to the training hall's secret cavern now. Alright, let's go. February 9th, Inner Temple Training Hall 9. Training hall. Just training hall. Fortunately, the sacred cavern hadn't caved in yet, but what we found was something none of us could have ever expected.
You're fucking with me.
How can there be more of them?
Even more locks.
What is the meaning of this?
Iris? Iris, please tell me, what the hell is going on?
No, oh. Game! Don't do this to me.
What the fuck is happening, man? Oh, I'm so confused. Alright. We're gonna take a short break here. I'm gonna see if my keyboard has dried out yet. I don't think it has, but, you know, might as well. I mean, I need to check as it's drying to see if it's getting sticky, because then I need to wash it again. So I'm gonna go check up on the keyboard, see if it's doing fine after the incident. And yeah, I'll be back. This should be like a 5-10 minute break thereabouts. So yeah, I'll be right back. And we are back, and as you can see, I never learned my fucking lesson. Never. Knowing how well this day has gone, I'm probably gonna end up spilling this again. We'll see. Let's get through this investigation. You know?
Ookie! Here we go!
I want to finish this game so that I can start doing, once I finish this game, I'm probably gonna start doing Nocturne 2 or 3 times a week. I don't know if I can handle 3, but I'll definitely do 2. And then I might do another game on Wednesdays, or I might go for 3 times a week on Nocturne, because I want to finish Nocturne before, in anticipation for Shin Megami Tensei 5 when it comes out, in November. They just released the trailer with gameplay, and it looks so fucking cool! The pro tag looks fantastic! Oh god, it looks so good! The trailer they released, if you want a Nintendo Direct today, they showed a trailer, yes, and it was garbage. Look up the Japanese trailer. The trailer that they used for the Western Nintendo Direct was, like, really dumbed down, I guess, because they were, like, trying to explain to people, like, oh, it's Pokemon, but you can negotiate with demons. But the one in Japan actually shows off gameplay, like real fucking gameplay, and it looks so fucking cool. Oh, I'm so excited for SMT5. Probably my most anticipated game of the year right now. February 9th, Inner Temple Training Hall. Enough talking about that. Let's get back into this. If we can. What is happening? All right, there we go. Right. Is this what Gato was talking about? Yeah, the trick locks. Now then, Iris, please remove these at once. Mr. Edgeworth, I'm afraid I can't. It's not possible for me. What? During the earthquake when the cavern was in danger of caving in, Iris escaped. But I know there was only one lock when I last came here.
Who the- So, what? There's just not a single police officer in this place? Where was Gato? Fucking went outside to go get another drink of coffee, and of course they slipped by him? He's literally the fucking worst! If Von Karma or Edgeworth were in charge of this investigation, she would have never gotten past them.
I mean, maybe Edgeworth, because he would have been knocked out, but, you know.
So, you're saying that you can't undo the new locks? Yes.
If only I was stronger! Edgeworth, how are you feeling? You look a little pale in the face. Like you want to talk with your face all green.
Miles, Edgeworth, go and get some air.
I like how all three of us are, like, working together now. It's great! We're a power team and a half, holy shit.
How much over the suspect? You go and get a grip on yourself.
Don't be ridiculous, I'm perfectly fine!
There's no telling what sort of mistake you could make in your current state. Go and get some rest. That's your only concern now, Miles Edgeworth.
Is she actually acting like a sister? That's cute.
Understood. I'll handle the investigation in the garden. You take care of things here.
Okay. We're all working together.
Edgeworth. He's got so much pride that he's probably off crying in a corner in the garden.
Pride is simply another trap that hinders us in our lives. That said, one must have pride to be effective on the job. At any rate, it seems that this is where we part ways, Phoenix Wright.
Oh my god, Von Karma being wise! Something that Gato could never understand because his metaphors are always fucking dumb as shit!
I'm gonna stay here and see if I can help solve this bothersome puzzle.
I see. Well, thanks for your help. Now then,
do you mind if I ask you a few things, Iris? No, not at all.
We still have another psyche lock that we haven't broken from her, right?
Why did you make a run for it, Iris? I'm sorry. I heard the inner temple had been severely shaken by a strong earthquake we had. I was so worried, I just came to see.
In other words, you didn't run away to escape the law. At least we're clear on that. I can't tell you how relieved I was when I saw the sacred cavern was all right, but... But what? Who the fuck put these locks up? There was no one here but Gato! Unless he actually... He's the fucking mastermind of this whole thing? Well, like, that's dumb! Like, that makes no fucking sense! Like, I mean, the man is dumb! And an idiot! And an asshole! But he wouldn't be doing a fucking murder thing, right? Plus, where'd he get these locks? What is it? Did he escape into the cavern? Is he hiding in there? What is this? What is this fucking retardation? Like, no, I it can't be fucking, like, that's, like, he wouldn't be that dumb. Oh, what?
I saw these chains here. I saw all these extra locks that someone had put up on the cavern door and... Who in this world would do something like this? These trick locks are the sacred treasure of the Kurain tradition. There are hundreds of ways to set them. That's why only the person who set the lock could open it. And you aren't the one who set these locks.
I don't think it's that simple, Franziska von Karma. When we were here the first time, there was only one lock. But now, somehow, there's five of them.
What does it mean?
It means that someone wanted to secure the place even more. And very crucially, that they managed to get in here while supposedly the police were, you know, having the run of the place. And they wanted to secure it before you got here, Iris. Presumably because they wanted to make sure Maya couldn't get out. This means that Iris can only open one of these locks, the first one.
Yes, that's correct. But... Iris, try to think, please. Is there any way around this? Well, like I said, there are 100 different ways to set these locks.
And 5 locks, that's... You know.
Suppose if I went through every combination with each one, I could remove them. But... It will take time, won't it? Yes, about a day, if I had to guess. All day? Well, that's better than leaving the locks in place. Will you do this for us? Sure, I'll do whatever I can.
Gotta wait another day. Hang in there, Maya. You're gonna have to call on your inner strength now. Give me an angle grinder! I'll get us in there in 5 minutes, tops! They call me the angle grinder master, okay? You know what, Iris? There's still one thing I don't quite get.
What might that be, Phoenix Wright?
I think it's obvious. Iris, on the night of the murder, where were you? Please, Iris, don't give me that look. You told us that you were in your room at Hazakura Temple at the time of the incident. But you were seen that same evening at the Inner Temple. And then, you were spotted at the scene of the crime in Hazakura Temple too.
Being spotted at both Hazakura Temple and the Inner Temple, it's as if you were.
Well, Iris, I think it's about time you told us the truth. Yeah, that's not happening. I knew it! There's something going on here that we don't know about! Alright. Doubt we can break it, but we'll see about it. This door. I was here earlier, there's only one lock, now there's 5 of them.
Those chains, it's almost as if they're guarding something inside the cavern. I've never seen locks quite like these before.
I've seen locks and chains just like... Yeah, okay. Dark secrets in a dark cavern. Probably. Now let's ask her about some stuff. Did you do this?
Yo! The locks are far more important at this moment, wouldn't you agree?
Fuck you, Von Karma. So I should probably get the dialogue here.
Locks are far more important at the moment, wouldn't you agree?
She's right. I'm gonna have to hold off on asking her about things for now.
I'm sorry, Mr. Wright.
Damn it. You won't even talk to me about Lori's docs, nope. Won't happen. Okay. I mean, she can look at stuff and talk while doing the locks. I talk while doing stuff all the time. Yeah, well, let's try to break the locks.
Love the shit stain turning blue.
Night of the crime. I think it's time you told the truth about what you were doing on that night. You said you were in your room at Hazakura Temple the entire time. Do you still claim that to be the truth?
Yes, that's where I was.
Iris, I believe you're innocent. That's why I want to believe what you're telling me. But I can't. Because this person saw you somewhere else on the night of the murder.
Bikini!
Take that!
I'm sorry, I'm talking about Sister Bikini, of course.
Sister Bikini?
Her testimony in court today was very clear.
That night I was helping an acolyte with her training in the Inner Temple, but... well, as you can see, my back legs act up violently. So I left Iris to help the acolyte and return to Hazakura Temple.
Sister Bikini didn't just see you, she spoke with you. You two talked about Maya's training that night. So you see, Iris, you were there at the Inner Temple on the night of the murder.
That's very impressive, Mr. Wright.
I mean, not really. I just had to read a fucking court record.
The acolyte's actual training was due to start after 10 o'clock that night. I left the main hall early, so I wouldn't be late.
What time was that?
Let me see. It takes about 20 minutes to walk between the main hall and the Inner Temple. So I would have left at about 9:40 p.m., I think.
I'm sorry, Iris, but lying just doesn't suit you.
Huh?
Now you say you left the main hall at 9:40 p.m., but what you say doesn't add up with this.
Right, ringing the lights up, though. You yourself testified to the contrary, don't you remember? You said you rang the lights out bell at 10 o'clock. Plus, only moments before you rung the bell, you were seen at the main hall by the most reliable witness I have!
Who's that?
Me! Give me a second here. Give me a sec, I need to do this real quick. Obama medal meme. Oh, spacebar doesn't work. Oh, that's great. That's fucking great. Why does the spacebar not work? Of all things, I need it to work. God damn it. No. Oh no, this keyboard. Jesus Christ. Oh my god, this is horrible. Actually painful to use this. Holy shit. Bunch of the keys don't work. And my on-screen keyboard isn't even loading up. Motherfucker. God damn it. Obama. Obama. Damn it! Medal. Oh, there we go. That's loading. Can we? This is very infuriating. Like, really, really infuriating. Oh my god. Can this load? Alright, fine, I'll do this some other time, and now it's in front of my game. Fantastic. I mean, you can't see it, because this... but why? Oh, that might explain it.
What screen? What key is that? Screen...
oh, this is concerning.
Yeah, the on-screen keyboard doesn't seem to work. Well, I was gonna do the Obama medal meme, but fuck me, I guess.
Mr. Wright!
We even spoke a little that evening. Yeah, this is fucked.
That's when you gave me this.
Surely you haven't forgotten.
No, that's right. I remember.
And that brings us to another puzzling fact, Iris.
at 10 o'clock on the night of the murder, you were seen in two different places at the same time. Son, you told me exactly what's been going on, Iris. So far, I managed to prove two things. First, on the night of the incident, you were at the Inner Temple. On second, at the exact same time, you were ringing the bell at Hazakura Temple. Only one possible explanation for this apparent possibility. There were two of you. On the night of the incident, you were seen in two different places at the same time. Which means there must have been two of you. I can't think of any other explanation, Iris.
But that's crazy. How could that be? There's only one of me. It's impossible.
Impossible? I wonder. The way you're trembling certainly seems to suggest otherwise.
You're seriously trying to suggest there's more than one of me? Then show me the evidence. Show me something that proves there's more than one of me.
Okay, I don't think we have this. Prax photo, the autopsy report. Do we have the Dahlia Hawthorne profile? We do not. I don't know. Alright, I don't think I'm ready for that one yet. Okay, well, let's go talk to Edgeworth then. Cops are still combing this place. They look pretty nervous. I'd be nervous too if I got. It's gotta be. Too. Fuck. It's got to be a tough job. Hi, Mark. Especially with someone giving you the evil eye the whole time. How could I have done that? I can't believe it's still bothering him. He needs a hug. Come on, Phoenix. Be a good boyfriend. Edgeworth. Hey, don't you dare run away. What do you want, right? What do I want? If you came here to laugh at me, then get on with it. Go on, laugh away. I was ready to hug it out with him, but he's just the same French philanthropist. There we go. See, we're on the same page here. You went back to the criminal affairs department, correct? You said you wanted to look into something concerning Iris. Yes. And thanks to what I found, I was reminded of something terrible. You guys are putting a lot of effort into the investigation of the garden here, huh? There's a high chance this is the actual scene of the crime, that's why. You mean because of the writing in blood and the talisman in the stone? Exactly. As you know, those things couldn't have been painted here after the murder. But surely, you don't suspect. Aya, do you? We have to treat everyone as a suspect. Maya, as well as Iris. That's our job, right? That is true. So, I guess you still haven't gotten over your fear of earthquakes. No, well, thankfully, my nightmares have stopped. But still, if the ground gives even the slightest tremor, I find myself short of breath. 17 years ago, when we were little school kids at the same elementary school, Edgeworth found himself in the middle of a murder. The P thought he committed. Funnily enough, what a wacky turn of events! It all started with that big quake that hit the courthouse. Yes, I'm stuck in the elevator with my father, who is a defense attorney. We were deprived of oxygen as we passed out. That's when it happened. A single gunshot shattered my whole life. I lost everything that day. All because of that earthquake. My dreams, my family, and myself. It's been more than 17 years now. That case was finally resolved 2 years ago, right? You think I don't know that? I was there! But it was a shock. I never imagined I could be so wrong about myself and my life. I'm sorry, right? There's nothing else I can say. Not after you chose to become a lawyer for my sake. Not after you saved me. Edgeworth, you're stronger than you think. So no more of this self-pity, okay? I'll hug! There was something that bothered me about her from the moment we met.
Felt like I'd seen her somewhere before. No, wait. Not somewhere, I felt like I'd seen her in court before.
So you went back to the Criminal Affairs Department to look for her file?
Yes, I checked over every case file I'd ever worked on. And I was right. I'd seen her face before 6 years ago.
6 years ago?
It was my first appearance in court. And as cases go, it was my worst nightmare.
So who is she?
I'm sorry, Wright. Can't give that information away to a member of the general public.
What? Why not? I might be a crucial piece of the puzzle to solve this case with an unheard defense attorney!
The woman I knew was the daughter of a jewelry store owner. She had nothing to do with the Iris, with Iris and Hasakura Temple. And neither did the case. No, that woman is completely unrelated to this murder.
Unrelated?
Yes, I can say that with complete confidence.
Why do I have a feeling it's not that simple?
You're wrong, Etrith. She's totally related to the case.
Manny, stop skirting around the bush!
I need to fill Etrith in. I need to explain the connection between Iris and the woman Etrith knew. I guess we can do that then. Apparently, Iris was taken in by the sisters here at the temple when she was a child. However, we still don't know much about her past, so we're looking into it.
That reminds me. Edgeworth went back to the Criminal Affairs Department to look up some stuff on her. I should ask him what he's found.
Damn it, then looks like I have to prove her connection with Dahlia Hawthorne, first of all.
Damn it!
The thing about this, Edgeworth. Sorry, Wright. You're a defense attorney and I'm a prosecutor. Wouldn't it be right for us to discuss things so intimately?
You were acting for the defense in the trial today! You're practically part of my defense team. Come on. We're in this together.
We're all in this together. Put of Elise, weather data, Shichishito, the staff. There's his testimony.
What do you want to talk about the picture?
Get that piece of filth out of my face!
You're still mad, huh, Edgeworth?
I know a thing or two about Larry Butts, just like you. We both know he likes to act up, but this? Even he couldn't make something like this up. If this is what he drew, then this is what he saw. As unbelievable as it may seem. I know, that's what I think too. Every single time I see that guy, he's in it up to his neck. I knew it, Edgeworth. Still mad at mad as a hornet at Larry. What do you think about? Facts, photo, testimony.
Shit. How do we prove Elise's true identity?
I mean, Iris's true identity, I guess.
Oh! The down key has stopped working.
Oh god, we're running out of keys by the second. Jesus Christ, also I should probably turn up the brightness of the my light since it's getting darker out.
Oh no, that's way too bright.
What about that? How does that look?
Yeah, alt key doesn't work. That's decent. I think that's still the best, but like, no, that's way too... Alright, well, let's... Nah, that makes me look kind of pale, you know? Alright, we'll keep it like it is. We'll see about moving it if we need to. So let's...
Fucking... Dahlia Hawthorne looking ass!
Let's take a look through the evidence. What can we use? Elise docks them in front of the garden of the inner temple. Outcropping near Dusky Bridge, his blood came from the victim's staff. Horrible sketch.
What we need is the profile of Dahlia Hawthorne so that we can present that to Iris. But in order to get that profile, we need to talk to Edgeworth.
Prairie knife, inner temple gate, but how do we break out? But how do we... What do we show to Edgeworth then?
Finally!
getting to the bottom of this case. I can count on Iris to break those locks, so I should try to gather more clues. Sister Bikini, Edgeworth, and Gumshoe. And Pearls. Oh, that's right. Where is she, actually? Guess we'll see. Suspension Bridge. The question is, what could have been burned? Because I doubt... You can't just burn the murder weapon, right? I mean, it was likely some kind of metal if it was a stabbing implement, right? It's hard to stab someone with a wooden sword, but I mean, it could be possible, but it would definitely... But no, it would leave splinters, and they would have found those on the body, so... She must have been stabbed with some kind of metal implement, which means it couldn't have been burned. So then what gives? Don't know. February 9, Dusty Bridge. Weird that there's no one around all of a sudden. Sure gets quiet up here in the mountains when you're all on your own. Speaking of alone, I guess I should go check on that shack just down the path. Maybe I'll find Larry down there. Maybe. And we shall.
Oh, Mr. Nick!
Pearls? What are you doing here?
Nothing. What about Miss Agmaya? Is she alright?
Well, we don't know yet.
Oh, I see.
Hey, what do you think you're doing here, Nick?
Larry?
It was the loser shack where losers get together to lose themselves.
I'm not a loser, I'm a fool. This is the what?
Hey, we might comfort each other's failures, okay? You got a problem with that?
Look, Mr. Nick, Mr. Larry's did a picture of me.
That's, great, Pearls.
We're going to get a firewood now. We'll be cooking some half-rotten potatoes over the miserable little campfire. So stay out of our way!
I don't believe this.
Why can't he try getting fired up over becoming a better man?
I don't believe a word I say anymore. Listen to me, Pearl. You don't want to trust this kind of guy, okay? He'll only let you down.
Oh, Mystic Maya.
What is going on here?
Larry, is there something you want to tell me about this picture?
I've got nothing to say to you, Nick. My life's here now. With Pearl, two losers cooking potatoes over together forevermore.
What am I going to do with them? Alright then, what do you think about this picture, Pearls?
I think it's really well drawn. I can't draw at all, so I think it's really amazing.
See, someone appreciates it. Stop getting the flames to look like that, you know?
I know. I've tried to draw flames before.
It's supposed to be Sister Iris flying through the air, isn't it? I love it. It's like a dream. A wonderful fantasy.
No. It wasn't a dream. She really flew. I'm telling you, Iris really flew that night.
Mr. Larice?
Oh. You too. Please don't look at me like that, Pearl. Don't look at me like I'm some kind of nutcase. I beg you.
I guess this picture really is a representation of Larry, of what Larry thinks he saw.
Okay, so I was half asleep when I was here that night. But I was wide awake after the lightning struck, and I saw what I saw. It was exactly like I drew in this picture.
And it looks like I don't have any choice but to take this sketch at face value.
Hey, what's the look of doubt on your face?
Oh my god. Pearls.
Yes, Mr. Nick?
I've been meaning to ask you about the night of the murder. Oh, she doesn't know. Oof! Oh, wait, that wasn't a good one.
Oof!
No, it starts with
oof!
Okay.
Oof!
Okay, that was a much better one. Where were you? What exactly were you doing when it all happened?
I was just, well, I'm just a kid, you know? I'm sure it doesn't really matter what I was doing, does it, Mr. Nick?
Sorry, Pearls, but yes, it does. On the night of the murder, you were supposed to be in Miss Doxnam's room reading a book together. But Miss Doxnam was murdered and you, Pearls, were at the Inner Temple.
Yeah.
So what exactly happened that night, Pearls?
I'm really sorry, Mr. Nick.
I'm gonna fucking kill someone.
I've been a bad girl. That's why I'm being punished.
What are you talking about, Pearl?
My spiritual power has disappeared.
What, her powers have disappeared? you mean your powers disappeared, Pearls?
It's all over for me. The spirit mage who can't channel spirits is like a painter who can't paint.
Case in point.
Hey, what are you looking at me for?
Pearls, could you try to channel someone's spirit right here at Hazakura Temple? Tried but failed, perhaps. Who is she trying to channel?
Way to go, Nick! You made her cry! That was really cruel of you!
Just as I thought, I'm gonna have to break the psychologs to get the truth out of her. God damn it! Why is everyone keeping secrets today? Jesus Christ! Night of the crime. To dinner on the night of the murder, you were supposed to be in Elise Doxum's room reading a book together, correct?
Yes! I'm so happy she invited me, but it didn't go. I didn't go in the end.
You didn't go.
No, it was somewhere else I had to go instead. I was so worried I had to go. I didn't know what to do with myself. I was so nervous.
So Pearls never went to Miss Dawson's room. She was too worried about something or someone else. Pearls, on the night of the murder, you went to this place. The Inner Temple to check up on Maya, right?
Take that!
You went here, didn't you, Pearls? Looks like she's still not going to open up to me. Here's where you went because you were so worried, right? The next question is, who or what were you so worried about? Now I'm gonna take a guess, and you can tell me if I'm right or wrong, okay?
You mean you know?
If I'm right, will you tell me the whole truth?
Okay.
You went to this place for a very simple reason, and that is this. Maya.
Take that!
It's obvious that you were so worried. What you were so worried about, Pearls? It was Maya, wasn't it? You knew the training Maya was undertaking was dangerous. After all, it was the special course. I signed up for your special course.
Well, my. Quite brave of you, considering how cold it is. Young people can be so reckless with their health. Don't blame me if you become one of those you channel. I'm about to murder someone.
Sister Bikini scared you with what she said, didn't she? Because of it. And because it was you who introduced Hazakura Temple to Maya in the first place, you felt responsible, didn't you?
Thinking about what could happen to Mystic Maya made me more and more worried. I couldn't sit still at all. That's why I decided to go and find what she was doing in the Inner Temple.
Then we're clear now that you went to the Inner Temple that day, Pearls. It's not clear as what happened after that.
No.
About what time was it that you headed over to the Inner Temple?
It was probably around 9:30 when I left the main hall. I heard the real training was supposed to start at 10. I wanted to get there before it started, but there was so much snow, I didn't get there until after 10 o'clock.
Until after 10? How did you know what time it was?
Because I heard the bell ring the lights out.
She heard the lights out bell? I think her temple's bell is pretty small, isn't it? You must be really good hearing.
Hey, I was really trying to pick up the sound of that bell, that's all. I didn't want to miss it. That would be terrible.
You was trying to hear the bell. Tell me, Pearl, why were you so worried about hearing the bell?
Huh? Oh, I
think I know why. The reason you're so worried about that bell was because of this. The bell? What about the bell? I'm too worried about running into... No, I don't think I have what I need here. Damn it! A dead end. Hmm. Real name Missy Faye. Mine is Mother and Master of the Korean Channel, if I mean. Should we tell her? I think we should tell her. Pearls. That's no good. She's in no condition to look at anything for me right now. Damn it. I mean, talk to Larry. No. Okay. Damn it! Well, in that case, let's, head back to the main hall, see if there's anything for us there. Wonder if Sister Bikini is back at the main hall yet. I haven't seen Gumshoe for a while either. Maybe they're having a cup of tea together somewhere. But Gumshoe's Sister Bikini's type. Yeah, it's big, gruff, man, you know? Oh, that doesn't look good. February 9th, Hazakura Temple, main hall.
Well, what's the damage? That was the secret cavern.
It looks like it survived. But we have a bigger problem now. Tell Sister Bikini all about it. About the five locks that were stopping us from getting inside the sacred cavern.
But who? Who could have done that? The only people who know how to set those trick locks are those of the Kurain tradition.
You have Iris at the sacred cavern. Oh. Actually, there's something I've been meaning to talk with you about, Sister Bikini.
Oh, yes. We were in the middle of a chat, weren't we?
Yes, you were telling me how the Master of Kurain disappeared 17 years ago. I want to know why Misty Face suddenly appeared at this temple.
It was about a week ago when Mystic Elise, Mystic Misty, arrived. After she showed me the talisman that proved she was the Master, she said, "Someone is trying to destroy the Kurain tradition's main family line. I'm here to put a stop to them."
Someone is trying to... Why, though? Like, the only person who has any motivation to do that is fucking... Morgan? But, I mean... Maybe Dahlia wants to take her revenge on Mia by fucking over her sister? I don't know! It's so confusing! Someone was trying to destroy the main family line.
There's only one heir to the title of Master at any time, and it's usually the eldest. A child becomes the new Master of Kurain, and her daughter is the main family. All other mediums become branch family members, with no hope of controlling the clan. That's why nothing has changed throughout the history of the clan. Branch families always have and always will plot to erase those of the main family line.
Is the power of the Master worth this much bloodshed? This always happens with main branch families. It's one thing Naruto has taught me.
You believe in the technique, don't you, Mr. Wright? You know the power is real.
Yes, I do. Been 2 years since I first met Maya. That time I've seen her channel the spirits of the dead plenty of times. During the Master Mask case. During Maggie Bird's trial too. Thanks to Maya, Mia's always on hand to help me out when I need her most.
The Kurain technique has made a huge difference to the world, you know? I mean, the ability to communicate with the dead, that's true psychic power, you know? Members of the tradition have always been there, behind every important leader. Who wouldn't respect such tremendous skill?
I suppose so, but... Well, the power and influence, I kind of expect you'd be really rich by now.
Are you saying we're poor, Mr. Wright? Oh, you're very direct, aren't you? People don't believe in it anymore, you see? All because of one little mistake.
A mistake? What mistake? The DL6 incident.
It was 17 years ago. That's when everything came crashing down. All because of that incident.
That incident? Is she talking about who I think she is?
I'm sure the records still exist if you're interested. Locked up, of course. It's called the DL6 incident. That's the name of the file.
The DL6 incident. I knew it!
Family feud!
The DL6 incident. I know it well. I handled a related case just 2 years ago. To solve the DL6 incident, in fact.
Ah, that's right. So it was you who was the defense attorney on that case.
A murder that took place 17 years ago.
It was the first time in the country's history that the police ever used a spirit medium. The idea was to channel the victim's spirit to learn the identity of the murderer. And the medium who performed the channeling was Misty Faye, Maya's mother. When Mystic Misty's channeling, the name of the certain man surfaced. Armed with that evidence, investigators were spurred into action.
But that man, he was found not guilty, wasn't he? And he actually was.
That's right, he was. And the case remained a mystery. In other words, we failed. It was the first case in the world. The first case the world had ever seen the Kurei tradition openly involved in. It was all over the media, the public, the judiciary, the people of Kurei Village. Everyone judged her. Everyone said mystic powers were a sham. And then she just disappeared, vanished, while everyone else thought of her as a fraud.
But I know the truth. Misty Face spirit channeling wasn't a sham at all.
Of course it wasn't. And since you managed to reveal the truth, we're finally making a comeback. The Kurei tradition is starting to recover at last, with a new master wielding the power of the clan.
She mean Maya?
The spiritual powers of the Kurei channel technique is in the blood.
Maya told me the exact same thing before.
Hey, the women of the Fae clan have always been spirit mediums. It's because the power to communicate with spirits flows strongly through us.
According to Maya, only the women in the family can inherit the power.
The main family bloodline stems directly from Mystic Amy. With each new generation, only one daughter becomes the new master.
And the ones who don't become branch families, correct?
That's right. And it's always the cause of tragedy.
You know, Maya had a sister too. An older sister named Mia.
Oh yes, I've heard of her.
What? You know about Mia?
Of course. She became a lawyer in the hopes of discovering what happened to her mother.
And lost her life as a result.
Do you know what Mystic Mia? Is rumored to have said. She said it wasn't only because of her mother that she became a lawyer. She also didn't want to fight with her sister over the leadership of the tradition.
Really?
Well, she saw what happened to her own mother, Mystic Misty, as she grew up. I guess Mystic Mia got tired of seeing all the rivalry between her mom and her aunt.
Yeah, Morgan is a fucking murderous bitch. That's right, Misty Faye had an elder sister too. And Misty, having superior powers, managed to usurp the master seat from her. Misty's sister is Mystic Morgan, as you probably know. Crazy bitch. Morgan, that's a name I know well. It was a year now at Maya's home, Crane Village. What she did was terrible. It was all so she can make her own daughter the next master.
I suppose if you know about Mystic Morgan's daughter, then you must have already realized that Iris...
Huh? Iris? What's Iris got to do with any of this?
That Iris is... Mystic Morgan's daughter.
What the fuck, game? What the fuck are you trying to pull here? What in God's name are you trying to pull? What the fuck? Okay, sure. I guess we can go with that. Sure. Okay, sure, fine. Iris is what? Is she kidding me? Iris is Morgan Faye's daughter? Did you just say Iris is Morgan Faye's daughter?
Oops, I thought you already knew. It sounded like you'd met one of Mystic Morgan's daughters already.
I have, I know her very well.
Oh?
Yes, Pearls. Pearl Faye. I always thought she was an only child.
You're just that child. She's Mystic Morgan's. I had no idea! Mystic Morgan! But she's in prison now, isn't she?
Yes, ever since she was found to be a co-conspirator in a murder case last year. It's all done to set Pearls up as the next master. I mean, I guess Iris can't be the master since she has no spirit power, right? Is it just coincidence that she looks so much like Dahlia then?
I see, something wrong all this time. Mystic Morgan had three daughters, not two.
No, I'm done. I'm done. I am done. I am done. The gem that was supposedly worth $2 million. It was green. The Mangatamas were green. This is, okay.
Wait, what? Three?
Yes, Iris, her twin sister, and Mystic Pearl.
This is a murder. This is a fucking murder case, and you did not think to mention a twin sister. Bikini, I am about to beat the shit out of you.
Oh, they are sisters. God damn it. So
what's up with Dahlia? She's not a fae. Is that a fake name? Was everything we knew about her fake? Did she, like, get fucking adopted by a different family? What happened?
What? Twin sister?
Oh, didn't you know? It all happened 20 years ago. After the clan leadership was taken by her sister, Mystic Morgan's life crumbled. It wasn't many years later that the Kurain reputation hit an all-time low. When Mystic Morgan's husband realized his wife would never become a master, he left her in the village, taking their twin daughters with him.
How awful!
He was a jeweler, you know? In the end, he remarried, and that's when it happened. He decided to give one of his girls up to be looked after by us here at the temple.
That
was Iris, you see?
So her and Dahlia are twins! Oh, God! Jesus Christ! It's unbelievable if Iris is a twin sister! Could it be?
Could you tell me one more thing, Sister Bikini? What was the name of Iris's sister?
I'm sorry, Mr. Wright. I just can't remember. All I recall is that her father was a jeweler.
That's a clue, I guess. A jeweler. Thank you very much. Helped clear up a lot of details. Pearls had two older sisters, huh?
Yes, that's right. No doubt about it. It was all because Mystic Morgan's anger towards the main family.
Anger? What do you mean?
Her twin daughters were taken from her by her jeweler husband, but even that couldn't destroy her dreams that a child of hers would one day lead the clan.
That's why she had pearls.
It seems that the incident here was a result of Mystic Morgan's anger. If it was able to break free of the bars that confined her.
So Iris has a twin sister. The plot thickens! This information will be useless unless I can flush it out a bit. Ask more questions about and get some info. How the fuck did she get out of prison then? So I'm guessing this is a new profile then. Faye's daughter, Iris' twin sister, her family deals in jewelry apparently. Alright. Let's take this to Dahlia. And if that doesn't work, we'll take it to Edgeworth instead. Inner Temple. Training hall. Here we go.
Take that!
You're not getting away from me this time, little bitch! This person saw you somewhere on the night of the murder. That is Bikini!
Take that!
Then her testimony with regards to the bell.
Take that!
Mm-hmm. Two of you. There's one, more than one of me. Your twin sister.
Mr. Wright, when you said there was another me, I was kind of expecting someone who looked like me, you know?
Guess so?
Okay, so you're saying that I look like this person?
I can't say with 100% certainty, but...
Can you show me something you're 100% certain of, then?
Shit, then we do actually need, to get Dahlia's picture. Got it. All right. Edgeworth! Edgeworth, did you know Iris had a twin sister?
What? A twin? You can't be serious.
Sister Bikini told me, but... Problem is, she didn't know the name of his twin.
There was nothing about Iris having a sister in the files I checked.
Well, Iris was taken in by the temple when she was really young. Apparently her sister was raised by her father. A jeweler, I think.
A jeweler? Right, I just might know who this twin sister of her is.
I had a feeling you'd say that. Let me guess. Her name is Dahlia Hawthorne, correct?
Yes, exactly. Please tell me what you know about her, Edgeworth. Please. It was my first court case 6 years ago. I was a greenhorn, and due to my inexperience, the defendant died.
Talking about Terry Falls, right?
You know about that case.
Not the only one who noticed something about Iris and Dahlia Hawthorne. I checked one of Mia's old files from 6 years ago. That was her first case, too!
Yes, Dahlia was a key witness in that case. Dahlia and Terry Falls conspired together to stage a fake kidnapping 11 years ago. They stole a jewel worth $2 million from Dahlia's father, a jeweler. And 5 years after that, she murdered her own sister, Valerie Hawthorne, to keep her from talking.
Her sister?
Well, her stepsister, actually. They weren't blood-related.
Right, they didn't really look that much alike, which is kind of what threw me off during that case.
Valerie was the only daughter of Dahlia's father's second wife.
Oh. This is when she entered my life. Well, she also murdered Gatto, too, first. Or Diego, at the time. The woman who tried to kill me. So, after Terry Falls died, what happened to Dahlia? Did you check that out?
Doesn't really matter. Like I said, Dahlia isn't connected to this case.
Why are you so sure about that?
It's simple. Dahlia Hawthorne is dead,
which means she's here and very much alive, and that's how she escaped prison. What?
Well, her metabolic process is a matter of interest only to historians, so to speak.
What do you mean by Dahlia Hawthorne is dead, Edgeworth? You claimed to be dead once, and here you are!
Right, I must confess that in reading her file, I came to know the murder case you were involved in during your college years. Dahlia Hawthorne was found guilty, thanks to the persistence of Mia Fey. Mia Fey! Mia Fey!
The fact that she was a Fey herself makes that even, her cousin, you know?
At the time, Dahlia, she was possessed by a demon or something.
It's almost been 5 years since the guilty verdict was handed down, and her sentence was finally carried out. She was executed last month.
Okay, good! 'Cause she deserved the death penalty! I'm glad she got it! You know what? I generally think the death penalty is barbaric and you shouldn't do that to anyone, but for her, I'll make an exception!
How the fuck did she survive?
Executed? I'm sure that's a bit of a shock for you, right? And for more reason than one. Do you understand now? She can't possibly be connected to this case. She's dead, and when someone is dead, there's no way to revive them.
But Gato died too.
There's no way to revive the dead. I wonder. Seems you're not aware of one other connection yet, Edgeworth. And what is that? It's about Iris and Dahlia Hawthorne's mother. What's their mother got to do with any of this? Right. If someone were to channel Dahlia's spirit, then she could technically still act and they would look like her too. Especially if the one channeling was her sister, Pearl Faye? It is a possibility, you know? After all, the murderer must have been left behind at the scene of the murder. And Pearl's was at the scene of the murder. If Pearl's channeled Dahlia, then... But the thing with that is that... We'll see. What's their mother got to do with any of this? She's Morgan Fay, a spirit medium from a branch family of the Kurine Channeling Technique. Did you say Kurine Channeling Technique? You know something about it? Oh yes, I know it's connected to that fraudulent spirit medium. Fraudulent, you say? I was involved in another nightmare 17 years ago. It's all coming together! I was caught up in the middle of a murder investigation. The police didn't have any leads. They were stumped, and that's when they called her in. She was a very famous spirit medium and the master of her channeling school. But you know what happened. As a result of her efforts, an innocent man was accused of murder. She and her powers, they were all fraudulent. Edgeworth. Go to the police records room, it's all there. All you have to do is check the DL6 incident case files and you'll know. Of course, how could I forget? Edgeworth was the victim in that case. Oh, one of the victims. Edgeworth. You'll understand someday. Then you'll see that the Kurine Channeling Technique is real. Well, is that it? Do we have the D? We have the D!
Deceased!
Oh no!
Alright, time to blow this case wide open, but before we do that, I need to go take a piss, so,
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
I've been muted this whole time. I'm fucking done. I can't do it. This has truly not been my day. Holy fuck. Oh my god. First, I'm late to the stream. Then, I accidentally mute myself. Then I fucking spill Coke all over my keyboard, and the replacement keyboard that I get, some of the keys don't even fucking work from the last time I spilled Coke on my keyboard. And then I muted myself again. Oh my god. This is truly going to go down in history as the worst stream I've ever done. This is horrible. This is horrible. Well, fine, sure. I guess what we need to figure... Well, what I was saying is that we need to figure out who channeled Dahlia, if anyone did. And we'll be doing that next week because I'm going to be busy on Thursday. We'll be back on Tuesday. Thank you for watching this horrible nightmare train wreck. Holy fuck.